Hi everyone, my name is Nick Shalom, the former Chief Software Officer for the Air Force and Space Force. When you finally understand what a service mesh is, so you're moving away from monolithic architecture and moving to microservices. That's right. You want to be more nimble? You want to enable your teams to pick the right technologies to get the job done. For example, different teams might need different programming languages or databases. You want to enable them to release at their own pace and move at the pace of relevance. More importantly, you do not want to have to wait for all the teams to be ready to be able to release to productions. Each team is able to release whenever they're ready to go live. So it's great. Now you have different teams using different programming languages, but you created a new problem. Those teams still have to do the basic things, such as API discovery, authentication, load balancing, and routing. Be able to also use mutual TLS tunneling to be able to securely communicate. If you have to do this the old-fashioned way, you would have to share libraries across teams, and you would have to manage libraries for each programming languages and share them across multiple teams. That creates tight coupling and a nightmare when it comes to updating software. So the beauty when you're moving to DevSecOps is that we create layers. We decouple the infrastructure from the platform, from the service mesh, and the microservices. That way, the platform can run on any cloud, anywhere at the edge, and your service mesh brings all these capabilities we just mentioned on top of the platform. Your microservices just inherit it without having to worry about it. That's why Istio, one of the leading service mesh, was created back in the day in 2017 by IBM, Google, and Lyft. In fact, the Istio team just finally announced they're going to be donating Istio to the CNCF. Istio uses another CNCF project, Envoy. Envoy is a reverse proxy that's injected as a sidecar container. A sidecar container is pretty simple. It's a smaller container that's injected into the pod of all your mission containers. That way, the sidecar and the container from your software are decoupled. You can update the sidecar container with no impact to your mission software. As you can see here, each service gets a reverse proxy Envoy injected as a sidecar container so that it can enforce the traffic according to your rules. One of the first benefits of a service mesh is about security. You can inject a mutual TLS tunnel thanks to the reverse proxy Envoy and make sure that service A has to be whitelisted to talk to service B. Istio automatically issues a short-lived certificate to perform authentication. Thanks to the automated injection of the sidecar container by Kubernetes, now you know that the proxy is going to be there alongside all of your services and that your entire traffic is now encrypted. Now, the second benefit is about visibility and making sure that your operation teams have the proper insights to make the right decisions. Of course, your service mesh is able to integrate into your SIEM and communicate with your security operations center. It gives you real-time security and threat visibility and response. With the creation of the ingress gateway, you are now able to also federate meshes and connect your different clusters, clouds, and on-premise environments. The other benefit of the service mesh is the ability to see what's running inside of your clusters. You're able to have a full set of service discovery, but also you're able to see in real time the health of those services. The service mesh also enables you to have access to modern routing capabilities. For example, you're able to perform A/B testing, gradual rollouts, canary releases, but you're also able to inject faults to be able to perform chaos engineering as well. Of course, the service mesh also acts as a layer 7 load balancer. Modern service meshes are also able to perform locality aware routing. That enables you the ability to route the traffic to the closest destinations to your users. We talked about the ability of your service mesh to look at the health of your services, but the mesh is also able to correlate your alerting and remediation. The real-time dashboards give you real-time metrics on your node, instance, and endpoints. you can see visually the health of your services and where the bottleneck might be. With the Streamlined Dev and Ops Views, you get that seamless dashboard with a unified single pane of glass. That gives you the full service topology graph with runtime visibility spanning across multiple environment clusters with unified mesh-aware logs, metrics, and traces. No more struggle to aggregate your logs. The Service Mesh is doing this for you. The Service Mesh aggregates your logs and telemetry across your enterprise. It also integrates with Zipkin and Skywalking to be able to perform tracing as well. Stay tuned for our next video on tracing as well. Some of the more recent features with products like the T-Trace Service Bridge on top of Istio also bring modern capabilities such as a web application firewall to be able to create custom policies so you can prevent situations like you've seen recently with Log4j. There you have it. The Service Mesh is a must if you're moving to microservices and you want to be able to move at the pace of relevance. You want to enable your teams to decouple, release at their own pace, but also not reinvent the wheel through libraries. By using the Service Mesh, the sidecar container is injected and all these capabilities are baked in. You enable them to do API management, service discovery, authentication, observability, but also modern routing with AB testing, gradual rollouts, canary releases, with retries, circuit breaker, and chaos engineering. You're also able to use the mutual TLS enforcement capability with a Service Mesh issuing short-lived certificate and implement zero trust so that container A to talk to B has to be whitelisted. And the most important, your Service Mesh is decoupled from your software so you don't have to reach out to all your teams to update the Service Mesh when it's time to because it's injected as a sidecar container. As you can see, the Service Mesh is a must, not just for your development teams, but also for your cyber teams as well. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. Click on the little bell to get the notification about our next videos. And we'll see you in the next video.